breaks between recording these calls. Not many are left, but still, I didn't think it would be this stressful. I've just got some notes, not a script or anything. I feel like I might be talking too much about things that are obvious for you, so I'm just going to wing this one. I think at this point you must be pretty confident with your job now, if you can even call it that. I think now might be a good time for you to know a little more about me. I have a feeling that you might be curious. Am I wrong? Right then. I was born in November 1968 in Texas, lived a fine life up until my teens, had no real problems with my family, but we weren't exactly rich. My father was an architect at the time, and my mother stayed home with my brother and I. Until the 80s, we lived in a flat, or I suppose it would have been called an apartment over there. It was pretty decent, I think, but honestly, I can't remember much. I had an accident in my teens, stuff I really don't want to talk about. Please don't ask. I might explain in a later call or something if there is time. Anyway, fortunately I survived the injury, believe it or not. It was all down to a very generous donor of blood. The whole thing was pretty strange and vague for us, and all I know is a small team of people, or maybe it was one person, was willing to give tons of blood to the hospital, and after an entire encyclopedia of signed papers, the transfusion was allowed on behalf of the procedure being an experiment. I was close to death, bear in mind. I lost most of my memory from before the incident, and the whole event caused a huge stir in the media. I was 18, and with the state I was in, paparazzi wasn't the best treatment, you know? So I sorted out something with my parents, and we moved here to England. So, hopefully on top of being a security guard, you can be a friend too. I wanted to get some of these stories off my chest for a while, since I don't have many people to share them with. And my daughter's kind of busy most of the time, just someone for me to talk to. And of course, listen to, so go ahead. What do you want to talk about? What else have I made? Well, this recording system has over 5 hours left on it, but I still don't think that's enough time to cover everything I've made. It's been a hell of a good hobby for over a decade now. I'll try to go over some of the more interesting things, though. In 2019, I made a self-driving car in my garage. The technology isn't that impressive nowadays, I know, but it was an amazing feat. It looked like garbage, but it worked. Since then, it's been modified to be road safe, and now my daughter uses it. Back in the late 90s, I made a few electric guitars, sold them to a secondary school, and in 2016, I made a video game with Bonnie's help. Oh, Bonnie's the name of my daughter, not sure if I mentioned that. Oh yeah, and of course I made the 3D printers recently, which helped me print smaller plastic parts for projects and toys and whatnot. That's really it, don't think I should mention anything else right now. Hope that clears it up. I've been a real busy guy, love creating things. See you on your fifth night.